Hi, and welcome to The Word with Pastor Michelle. Today we're talking about influencers. And influencers is a term that's used in social media to basically highlight people who have a large following and have the ability to influence other people. Well, God was the original influencer, and he has set up his people in the earth to be influencers as well. So today we're going to talk about influencers and impossible tasks. We're going to go to the book of Daniel, where we find King Nebuchadnezzar in a situation where he couldn't sleep. He had this very bad dream, and he wanted someone to tell him what the dream meant. Now, he wasn't going to tell him what the dream was for them to interpret. He was like, no, you need to tell me what I dreamt and what it meant. And in a way, that's actually pretty smart, because that way people, he would know for sure if they are really hearing about what it was he dreamt. So anyway, Daniel chapter 2, verse 2 says this: he called in his magicians, enchanters, sorcerers, and astrologers, and he demanded that they tell him what he had dreamed. As they stood before the king, he said, I have had a dream that deeply troubles me, and I must know what it means. Then the astrologers answered the king in Aramaic, long live the king, tell us the dream, and we will tell you what it means. But the king said to the astrologers, I am serious about this. If you don't tell me what my dream was and what it means, you will be torn limb from limb, and your houses will be turned into heaps of rubble. But if you tell me what I dreamed and what the dream means, I will give you many wonderful gifts and honors. Just tell me the dream and what it means. And so he was very serious about this. And when I was studying this, it dawned on me, as believers, as spirit-filled believers, people who follow Christ, we're going to get asked to do impossible tasks. And the thing about it is, we don't need to be worried or scared, because we have access to the Most High God, the God who knows everything anyway. And so when this information came to Daniel that all the wise men and astrologers and magicians were getting ready to get killed because nobody could tell the king his dream, Daniel did not panic. He brought his friends together and they prayed, and they acknowledged that they knew themselves they couldn't do it. There was nothing about them that enabled them to do it, except that they knew to go to God. And so in your situation, or situations that you may face in the future, if you're given an impossible task, don't fear it. Embrace it, and then go and commune with the Holy One of Israel, your Heavenly Father, and ask him to help you to know what it is you should do in this situation. Let's see what Daniel did. When he finally prayed with his friends and got an answer, he came to the king. Verse 26 of Daniel chapter 2, it says this: then the king said to Daniel, also known as Belteshazzar, is this true? Can you tell me what my dream was and what it means? Verse 27, Daniel replied, there are no wise men, enchanters, magicians, or fortune tellers who can reveal the king's secret. But there is a God in heaven who reveals secrets, and he has shown King Nebuchadnezzar what will happen in the future. Now I will tell you your dream and the visions you saw as you lay on your bed. Now, you know the king had to have fallen out after that, right? Okay, but Daniel gave honor and glory to God. Daniel did not take this on as his own gift. He acknowledged that God was the source of this information, and only his God could do such a thing. This is very exciting. We can see the pattern here. Daniel went to God, prayed, and then when he got the answer, acknowledged God before he delivered it. This actually led to Daniel and his friends being promoted. And, you know, I don't know if you're in a promotion, that's great. But here's the thing: we get to influence and bring glory to God when we answer impossible tasks by tapping into the wisdom of God. So as you have opportunity to be an influencer, don't shrink back from impossible tasks. Embrace them and go to God and ask him for what the solution is, and bring glory to him. Be blessed.